This is the Radia WindRunner, world's largest plane now, and it is a new engineering feat that defies expectations and looks to make transporting the biggest of items possible in the future. With the notable exception of the Large Hadron Collider, there's really no machine in history with single parts larger than today's mammoth wind turbines. Some offshore turbines, for example, are being built with blades more than 140 meters long. One of the reasons why they're not getting to this scale on dry land is that it's damn near impossible to move blades this size on the road. Corners are too tight, bridges are too low, even blades half that size are a logistical nightmare, and sometimes the process is pretty terrifying to watch. But size really matters in wind power, where the swept area of your turbine is the key factor in how much energy you can harvest. The tips of the blades sweep a larger area than the sections closest to the hub, so there's a disproportionate area gain to be made for every bit of length you add. If onshore wind could start using blades nearly the size of what's being used offshore, more wind energy could be harvested at lower cost. Thus, the idea of the Radia WindRunner, a transport solution you could design an entire turbine manufacturing operation around, and indeed one that wind farms would need to factor into their plans from day one, because it's totally focused on moving absolutely colossal turbine blades. If it was 6 feet longer, the WindRunner would stretch the entire length of an NFL football field, and with its 261 feet wingspan, it's nearly 3/4 the width too. At 79 feet high, it's no taller than an Airbus A380, but its flip-top front, with the cabin elevated right up at the top of the fuselage, allows the 354 feet long plane to carry cargo up to 344 feet in length, and 24 feet in diameter. Maximum payload weight is a whopping 160,000 pounds, maximum range is around 1,200 miles mark, and the volume of the cargo bay is some 272,000 cubic feet, 7 times more than the mighty Antonov could offer. It'll be rather big. The idea is that you'd put an airstrip as close to your blade manufacturing facility as possible, and another right there at the location of the wind farm. You'd load a blade straight into the plane from the factory floor, and likewise you'd crane it up for installation pretty much straight out of the back of the plane. In order to facilitate this kind of behavior, the WindRunner is designed to take off and land on a relatively short 6,000 feet airstrip. To put that into perspective, your typical, much smaller passenger airliner typically uses a strip between 30 to 110% longer than that. Radia doesn't even expect a proper paved airstrip. Presuming that a lot of wind farms will be built in open, flat country, it's designed the WindRunner to operate on semi-prepared airstrips, that is to say, simply an area that's been cleared of rocks, bushes, trees, and other obstructions, like what a military aircraft might land on during an operation. The WindRunner is a lot more than a set of renders too. Radia has apparently raised $104 million to the cause, and the company estimates that the bigger turbines it unlocks for onshore wind developers could reduce their cost of clean energy by as much as 35%, and make wind farms viable in a much wider range of locations. The company apparently believes it'll have the WindRunner built, tested, and certified within around 4 years. Certainly a remarkable project, and possibly one that could crack open all kinds of opportunities for clean energy developers once it's airborne. We look forward to following progress on this monster machine.